Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Ako'y nagpupuli, nagpupuli sa Panginoon. Nagagalak ang aking espiritu sa aking tagapagligtas.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the solemnity of the Annunciation of the Lord. Today, the Word became flesh. God became man. Today, our salvation has begun. And so to become less worthy to participate in this sacred meal, let us now humbly call to mind our sins and beg the forgiveness by which we are renewed. Hence. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O
Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
O God, who will that your word should take on the reality of human flesh, in the womb of the Virgin Mary, grant me, pray that we who confess our endeavor to be God and man, may Mary be become our neighbors even in this divine nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, "Ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the netherworld or high as the sky." But Ahaz answered, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David, is it not enough for you to weary people? Must you also weary my God? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will.
Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will.
Sacrifice or oblation you wished not, but ears open to obedience you gave me. Holocaust or sin offerings you sought not. Then said I, "Behold, I come."
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
In the written scroll, it is prescribed for me. To do your will, O my God, is my delight, and your law is within my heart.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
I announce your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips, as you, O Lord, know.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Your justice I kept not hid within my heart. Your faithfulness and your salvation I have spoken of. I have made no secret of your kindness and your truth in the vast assembly.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, it is impossible that the blood of bulls and goats take away sins. For this reason, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offerings you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me. In holocaust and sin offerings you took no delight." Then I said, "As is written of me in the scroll, behold, I come to do your will, O God." First, he says, "Sacrifices and offerings, holocaust and sin offerings, you neither desired nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law." Then he says, "Behold, I come to do your will." He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will, we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" The angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus became man not only on the day he was born and that we celebrate on Christmas Day, December 25. The beginning of the incarnation of Jesus, the beginnings of the God becoming man, happened today as the angel announced to Mary God's plan for her and for the world. And when Mary gave her assent, her yes to the will of God, then Jesus became flesh in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Jesus became man, and incarnation, our salvation, began. And so today, we are 9 months away from Christmas. From today, the Blessed Virgin Mary will carry in her womb the Son of God, the Savior of the world. And it all began with an announcement of an angel and with a yes of Mary. That is why you will observe that our readings today all talk about announcements. Obviously, in the Gospel, we heard the annunciation of the Lord's birth. The angel Gabriel announced to Mary the will of God for her, that she has been chosen to be the mother of the Savior. And to this announcement, the response of Mary was, "I am the handmaid of the Lord, let it be done to me as you say, as you announced it to me." Our second reading today from the letter to the Hebrews is also a sort of an announcement. Our second reading today announces to us the yes of Jesus to the plan of God for him. If in the Gospel it was about Mary's yes, in our second reading it was the announcement of Jesus' yes to the Father's plan for him, that he would become man and that he would offer himself for the salvation of the world. And because of the obedience of Jesus and the obedience of Mary, what God himself announced 1,000 years earlier, as we heard in our first reading today, was fulfilled. In our first reading, God announced his plan of salvation. A virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. That announcement, that prophecy was fulfilled in the Blessed Virgin Mary and in Jesus, who both gave their consent, their yes, to the will of God announced to them. My dear brothers and sisters, every day we also receive many kinds of announcements. Marami tayong announcement na hinihintay at naririnig araw-araw. Before COVID-19, I'm sure when the weather is not good, when it is raining hard, students are waiting for an announcement of suspension of classes. At kung akala ng mga estudyante na sila lang ang naghihintay ng announcement na walang pasok, ang mga teacher din excited ng announcement ng walang pasok. We wait for announcements of holidays. We wait for announcements of bonus. Hinihintay natin ang announcement ng promotion. Hinihintay natin ang announcement ng magagandang bagay na darating sa atin. Yung mga kumukuha ng board exams, hinihintay ang announcement ng result ng exam. Dito sa Archdiocese of Manila, naghihintay din po kami ng announcement. We are waiting for the announcement of our next Archbishop, of the new Archbishop of Manila. We wait for many announcements. We hear many announcements. Araw-araw hinihintay natin, no, ilan na naman ba ang new cases ng COVID-19. We wait for the announcement of the arrival of the vaccines. We wait for the announcement when the vaccines will be available for everyone. Ang daming announcement na hinihintay natin araw-araw. Some announcements bring us joy, but others bring us sorrow, sadness, and despair. My dear brothers and sisters, what announcement do you await in your life right now? Ano ba yung hinihintay mong marinig mula sa iyong kapwa o mula sa Panginoon? My dear brothers and sisters, like Mary, let us listen to the announcements given to us. And let us be discerning. Let us discern whether these announcements are truly the word of the Lord. Let us discern, because when we discern, when we realize that what we hear comes from the Lord, then we have to respond in obedience, in trust, and in faith. As we hear many announcements that come to us every single day, every announcement invites us to a response. And let that response, whether it is the will of God, whether it is for our own good, let our response be like the response of Mary. If the announcement is the will and the word of God, let us say, yes, let it be done to me according to your word. For who knows, the announcement only awaits our consent in order for the plan of God to be realized. Baka hinihintay lang ng announcement ang ating pagtugon para maganap ang plano at kalooban ng Diyos. And so listen well to announcements. Listen well, because God might be speaking to us through these announcements. And when we hear God's word, let us say, like Mary, I am the handmaid of the Lord. I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be done to me as you say. And through us, salvation will happen here and now.
Please stand.
We shall now profess our faith, and after we have said the words, He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, we shall pause for a while, we could kneel, and let us briefly reflect on the mystery of the Incarnation of God. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary,
suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified,
died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Through the faithful obedience of the Blessed Virgin Mary, God takes flesh among us. The mystery of the Incarnation calls us to our loving Father through the incarnate Son. For every petition, let us say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that the Church may be seen as the incarnation of the working body of Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people of goodwill may learn that Christ has united himself with every person in taking our human nature. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That scientists and technologists may work with novel ideals to further human dignity and happiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That pregnant mothers may welcome the new life as Mary welcomed her son. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may be forgiven of their sins. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray silence for our petitions. Let us pray for the people who need our prayers and for the intentions offered in these months. Father of the incarnate word, we bring our intentions before you. The fabric of our daily lives made holy by your Son, our brother in the faith, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, Almighty God, to accept your church's offering, so that she who is aware that her beginnings lie in the incarnation of your only begotten Son may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this solemnity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the Virgin Mary heard with faith that the Christ was to be born among men and for men's sake, by the overshadowing power of the Holy Spirit. Lovingly she bore him in her immaculate womb, that the promises to the children of Israel might come about and the hope of nations be accomplished beyond all telling. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May your voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Broderick our administrator and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Father as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of the true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that He who was conceived of the Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of His resurrection, merit to attain eternal joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Are you?